this video, I'm going to share 3 new journals with you. I really like these journals because they have my artwork on the front and back. They are really nicely made. 2 of them have really thick paper. So it's really a sketchbook. It's 140 DSM ivory white paper. And so far I haven't tried it. I thought I'd do that on camera. This is one of them. I choose my own art. This is a crayon and watercolor page that I made. Here's the second one with 2 different artworks, one on the front, one on the back. You get to pick your own color of ribbon for closure and for bookmark. So I picked, of course, pink. The third one I ordered and asked for is this one with an acrylic art journal painting on the front, where I also added my studio name and my URL for my blog and business. But this one has a bit thinner pages. So this is for me, this is a writing journal or notebook, and the other ones are more for art, and I'm really wanting to get into them. So let's do that. Let's just try the paper out. So since this one is the blank thin paper, and you know how thin paper is, it's like printed paper, 90 DSM. I'm not gonna do anything in this. I'm gonna use it as my writing journal. Probably it's going to be rather private observations and thoughts inside. So now, which one of these am I going to pick? It's really difficult, but I'm thinking I'll use the bluebird since I really like this one. And this is more of a classical kind of design, so I can keep it. And I didn't put any logo or anything on it. So Studio iHanna and my URL on this one feels like this is also rather raw. And I want to get into sketching and drawing and painting in this one. So we'll see what the page can take. Let's see what kind of pens we should try. I have my Lamy markers and trusted Sharpie, who always bleeds, and a normal black pen. And what's more, gel pen and ink one. So you can write your name at the front. And this one, first page is glued, so I usually just jump over that. And if we're going to do a pen test, maybe we should do it in the back, because I hear that's most common and it's a good practice. So let's just start with the worst one. Fluorescent marker. These are for marking things in textbooks, but I'm really a fan of neon and fluorescent, so I'm using them to color stuff with. You can see everything through these pages, actually. This is a Pilot V sign pen. Old one that's still working perfectly. I really like the ink in this one. And then just a jelly roll. So this is what pencil and a couple of ink pens looks from the back of the paper. And I don't think this is very disturbing. I think it will be covered up when I draw other things. So I'm going to try with some water media on this page, just because I really enjoy both acrylics and watercolors, and I really wanted to try that on this kind of page too. Some doodle clouds.
bit of sunshine coming in. Well, it's a kind of green sun. And just to complete the test, I'm also going to add some acrylic paint to this page. Or maybe to another page. And of course, watercolors is the trickiest one since it's the wettest. So if it can take watercolors, it can take most anything. So I just wanted to try this out. So as you can see, most pens and watercolors and some bit of acrylics works on this page. I wouldn't use it for watercolors mainly, but from time to time I might add in some. I'm mostly going to use it as for drawing and sketching, and I think that will be just fine. See, it bubbles a bit. But as it's in a great book, you can just close it. I have finished my pen test and closed the book before it was dry, so it's a little smudged. But overall, I think this is great paper, and I think it will work for an art journal, even though I think I will doodle and sketch and color in a lot with pens and pencils more than with watercolors and acrylics. But we'll see, and probably I'll also add some collage elements, because that's what I usually do in my books. Even with the bleeding, I think I can live with that. So I'm not going to use the Sharpie, that's for sure. I love making custom stuff. I have made my own magnets, calendars, and I made photo books on my own. And it's just super fun to see your designs on other things than just your regular art paper or canvas. So if you're an artist or pattern designer or any kind of visual thinker, I think you should try this out. It's not too expensive as it was a couple of years ago when anything custom was like blown up in proportion for what you got for the value. That concludes my review of this book from BookBlock. Me, you can visit my blog at ihanna.nu, which means now in Swedish, and you can read the accompanying blog post to this review. And if you feel like giving me any comments or feedback, please do so, but be kind. This is my first YouTube video. Thanks for watching. Oh, and subscribe. Please subscribe. Bye! Turn out okay. I'm not gonna post this. I'm not gonna post this. I mean, this is the book. I'm not gonna post my face. Hi, have you seen this notebook? I made it. Or no, BookBlock made it. I designed the cover. I love the cover. Thanks for watching.